Hello, I'm Marije Jansen, and I'm a professor in ICT and governance at Delft University of Technology. In this talk, you will learn the prominence of ICT for the performance of infrastructures, the typical challenges faced when designing ICT for information exchange, and the need for guidance of ICT developments by information architectures. In particular, we will focus on interoperability, referring to the ability of disparate systems to work together. The use of the term infrastructure might be confusing, as IT is a critical infrastructure in itself. There are some calculations that show that more than 50 billion euros a day will be lost if the internet fails. This is shocking. The dependencies between infrastructures are becoming so high that due to the failure of the ICT infrastructures, other infrastructures like water and energy might fail. We don't know if those calculations are correct, but it's easy to imagine that a failing internet will have a huge impact. The focus of this lecture is on the role of ICT for supporting other infrastructures. I will use the example of a smart grid for clarification. Also, the need for information sharing and using information plays a huge role. Often, this is done as an afterthought. However, after realizing that interruptions and flaws in ICT might disrupt the complete infrastructure, it becomes already clearer why it's necessary to design information infrastructures in advance. The amount of available data grows, both the amount of structured and unstructured data. Structured data is stored using predefined attributes, often in databases. An example is your address information, having a certain format. It includes a street name, a street number, a zip code, and a place of residence. In contrast, unstructured data have no structure in advance. Examples are discussion forums, blogs, and other social media. Furthermore, sensors like videos, traffic movement, temperatures, telescopes, and so on collect a big amount of data that can potentially be used. This is called the Internet of Things, referring to the integration of several technologies and communication solutions. The Internet of Things employs sensors and actuators to measure and infer in the environment. You might already make use of those sensors, the location device on your smartphone as an example. The thermostat at my home can be remotely controlled. If I'm cycling home in the winter, I can provide a signal to my house and it will be warm on arrival. I can view the yield of my solar cells using my tablet, which is good as they are not located at the roof of my house. Smartphones have likely many sensors. All this could provide very valuable insights. In particular, by combining various sources of data, it's possible to create added value. For example, if the sun is shining and the yield of my solar cells is too low, there could be a problem with the installation of the solar cells. Measures might have to be taken. A main challenge is that the need for information is often difficult to elicit in advance, and over time, the need for information can change. Combining information is not easy, because information is often provided by different systems using different types of protocols that are unable to communicate with each other. A smart grid combines various means for generating energy, and in a smart grid, a variety of energy users come together. Smart grids need the integration of high-speed, reliable, and secure data communication networks to manage the complex power systems effectively. A smart grid and the interaction between the remote electric devices in real time have to be controlled. The key to this is having the right information. The smart transmission infrastructures are expected to employ new technologies and to enhance smart grids, which complicates the design. The smart substations are expected to coordinate a local device based on the information available. The information is scattered around the network. Plant operators collect and share information about their electricity production, maintenance window, maximum capacity, and so on. On the other hand, customers collect information about their own use and about their own devices. Information is everywhere, which makes it difficult to find and to share. Nevertheless, most value is created when information sources are combined. For example, the supply and demand needs to be balanced to avoid overcapacity in a smart grid. For this purpose, various organizations need to cooperate and exchange information with each other. Only by having the right information, this can be accomplished. Each actor has its own need for information. The information you need could be the price of the electricity to ensure that your washing machine might only start when the price is below a certain threshold. This means that information should be shared and interpreted. Furthermore, the possibilities for an automatic start should be implemented in the washing machine. Sharing of information demands interoperability. There are many challenges for exchanging information. Exchanging information demands interoperability. The Institute of Electrical and Electronics Engineers, IEEE, defines interoperability as the ability of two or more systems or components to exchange information and to use the information that has been exchanged. In short, interoperability is the ability of disparate systems to work together. A common distinction in interoperability is between the technical, syntactic, and semantic level. Making a distinction between layers helps to deal with the complexity. Furthermore, each layer can be designed independently of the other layers. We will use those layers to show that there are challenges on each of them. Technical interoperability refers to network connectivity. Syntactic interoperability refers to the structure and adherence to standards. The level of semantic interoperability takes care that information is interpreted in the same way. Sometimes a fourth level is added on the top. This level is called the pragmatic level. Let's take a look at each level. A fast, reliable, and secure communication networks play a vital role in the management of a smart grid. The network is required to connect a large amount of devices. The technological layer refers to the transportation network, which includes elements like security, reliability, domain names, and authentication. This layer contains the internet, mobile cellular networks, satellite networks, community networks, wired and wireless local area, and personal networks. Our network infrastructure should be able to meet the real-time, reliable, and secured communications. This puts higher requirements than the networks we often use in our daily life. For example, redundancy is important in the design to ensure fallback options when a part fails. The syntactic layer should ensure that the data that is being exchanged has the same structure and adheres to the same standards. An example is an order having a certain structure, number, amount, price, described in the extensible markup language, abbreviated as XML. Both the sending and receiving party have to agree on this structure. If they agree, the data will be sent over the network infrastructure. The third layer is the semantic layer, with its mean to ensure that the communicating systems interpret the system in the same way. Semantics provide meaning and is necessary to refer what data denotes. For example, bank can refer to a talus, a bank of clouds, or an organization handling financial transactions. Raining cats and dogs should not be interpreted as that cats and dogs are falling from the sky, but as heavy rain. On top of this level, the pragmatic level can be positioned. Pragmatic interoperability refers to all organizational and collaborative aspects related to the quality, trust, service agreements, and context-sensitive aspects of meaning. This includes the service-level agreements with the parties that you trust. Service-level agreements contain information that is expected from other organizations. These expectations are often related to the functioning of the systems, like the availability of the systems, response time, dealing with changes, and so on. Information quality is always a big issue. But how do you know if the information is correct? What will happen if there are conflicting information? How do you know which information is correct if the information is conflicting? Furthermore, governance is necessary. Who decides on the changes which affect the system level? How are the decisions made? Often, a narrow view on semantics is taken. A broad view takes the context into account. For example, In a narrow view, winter might mean snow and sledging. But someone living in the south might have a winter without any snow. This can only be revealed if the context is taken into account. On all the interoperability levels, we have seen challenges. Higher layers depend on the functioning of the lower layers. There are many challenges facing our society. Somebody is taking over your washing machine and let it use energy only when the price is high instead of when it is low. This might cost you a lot of money. Or even worse, the hacker let the drum turning faster and faster till there is a fire. Professor Michel van Eeten will tell you more about the security aspects. Information architecture aims at directing the design and development of ICT. Information architecture contains decisions made at each of the levels to ensure interoperability. The ICT infrastructure we outlined here needs to be flexible enough to be able to deal with changes originating from all kinds of sources. In the next lecture, we will focus on principles for creating flexible information architecture to meet the challenges of the future. Thank you very much for your attention, and I hope that you've enjoyed the lecture.